This your girl, Minister Joelle Stamps, back with another video. Today's video will be on the Kingdom of God versus the Kingdom of Darkness. What is the Kingdom of God? The Kingdom of God is an organized structure of God's wills, laws, authorities, plans, ways, desires, and character of Father God, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Let's go into Psalms 103:19 and Psalms 22:28. The Lord hath prepared his throne in the heavens, and his kingdom ruleth over all. For the kingdom is the Lord's, and he is the governor among the nations.
The Lord Jesus introduced is a kingdom government, which is built on his government, his word, his lordship, and his purposes. So contrary to democracy, the Lord's government is about him, his say, his way, because it is his kingdom government.
Who is a part of the kingdom of God? The Trinity is a part of the kingdom of God, Father God, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Father God is the king that reigns over the entire universe and over his kingdom, the kingdom of God. And he makes this happen through the blood sacrifice of Jesus Christ and through the supernatural influences and workings of the Holy Spirit. Let's go into 1 Corinthians 8:6. Yet for us, there is but one God, the Father, from whom all things came and for whom we live. And there is but one Lord, Jesus Christ, through whom all things came and through whom we live. How to identify the kingdom of God? You can identify the kingdom of God by looking at the fruits of the Spirit within a person, place, or thing. Let's look at the fruits of the Spirit in Galatians 5:22-23. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law.
I thought I'd wear a shirt today, you know, being the last day and all.
Well, thank you. Thank you. We appreciate that. But wear one tomorrow, though, okay? Because tomorrow's going to be your first day. If you'd like to work here as a broker. Would you like that, Chris?
Yes, sir.
Good. We couldn't be happier. So, welcome. Was it as easy as it looked?
No, sir. No, sir, it wasn't.
Well, good luck, Chris.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Oh, Chris. I almost forgot.
Mama! Mama!
Oh my God, Mama! Try what happened. Try what happened. Talk to me. What happened? What happened to Ricky?
Trey?
Talk to him. Something just happened to Rick. I don't know. know. It just got shot. Wait.
Now, Granny, I want you to try and calm down, and I want you to go home. You hear me? You hear me?
Yes.
Don't worry. I'll take care of him. He's going to be all right. Trey? Trey, what are you doing? Huh? Oh, you bad now, huh? You bad. You gotta shoot somebody now, huh? Well, here I am. Come on, shoot me. You bad, right? Look, I'm sorry about your friend. My heart goes out to his mother and his family, but that's their problem, Trey. You my son. You my problem. I want you to give me the gun. Oh, I see. You want to end up like little Chris in a wheelchair, huh? Right? No. You want to end up like Doughboy, huh?
Things that belong to the kingdom of God include worship to Jesus Christ. Forgiveness.
I was always a rebel. Got caught in church with pot and different things, you know. And I went to church camp back when I was 16. And that's where I was saved. And me, like a lot of people, they think when you're saved, then you can go do what you want. You know, you're saved and God's going to forgive you. And, you know, but I found out that's not true. Because I went the next, I don't know how many years, doing what I wanted to do and not what God wanted me to do. Actually, we should probably back up to when I was molested at 13. That kind of put me on a downhill spiral. 2 days ago, as you look at me now, I'm back to being who God wanted me to be as a man. And it doesn't really matter what I got between my legs because no one's going to see it anyway. And I've been reading my Bible every day, and all I could hear was God saying, well, you really need to go back to being who I made you. Without the Lord, you'll have nothing. You'll have nothing. You know, He's the vine and we're the branches, and we can do nothing without him.
In kindness. Who are the agents of the kingdom of God? God uses his mighty angels and the followers of Jesus Christ to carry out his plans, wills, and desires, and to battle against the kingdom of darkness. To receive the love of Jesus Christ, to bring people to Jesus Christ so that they can receive the kingdom of God and have eternal life in heaven after death, and to guide each person into their God-given purposes and destinies here on earth. A lot of God's children have been snatched up by the hands of Satan. The kingdom of God is about saving souls from the grips of the devil.